Okay, welcome back. Day two of the Splunk Conference. This is SiliconANGLE, Wikibon's theCUBE, our flagship program. We go up the events, instructor student from the news. I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE.
I think one of the things that's striking with Splunk and the party last night was the celebration around the IPO and the success that they've had. One of the things that's very clear is, you know, Splunk is not stopping. I mean, they're like innovating, and IPOs can derail a company, and basically they're shipping code. I mean, one of the things that really hit home with me in talking to some of the Splunk employees was they are still shipping product. There's a passion for the product. It's a product-centric company, very customer-centric, and it's very clear. But they do like to let some steam go, Dave. They like to party, but again, the IPO is clear that that is just one hurdle. They're still cruising altitude right now, is my opinion. And again, you know, they're not stopping at the IPO. They're continuing to grow. And again, the passion for the product, that's my big takeaway, is that, you know, the folks here are excited for the IPO. They're excited for the growth. More importantly, they're excited about the product and the customers.
Well, I think as well, you know, when you do an IPO, obviously you go from under the radar to right in everybody's face. You know, the competition is watching. So the thing is that Splunk is growing very, very quickly. We're seeing a 50% growth per year. This is going to be, by my predictions, a $300 million company, you know, this year within their fiscal year. The street's estimates are a little lower, but I think a conference like this, John, with all the enthusiasm I'm seeing, I think they're going to get a huge halo effect from this. Point is, everybody's now watching, right? You've got the big established IT players saying, oh yeah, we can ingest machine data and log data, and we can help our IT customers as well, so they're going after that. You've got some open source alternatives trying to go after Splunk now. So the key is, Splunk knows this, so what they're doing is they're trying to stay ahead of the curve. They're expanding, you know, they kind of landed, you know, to use Tableau's term, they landed already with sort of the helping the IT folks, you know, do some monitoring, but they're going way, way beyond that. So you saw that yesterday in several examples. One is Hunk, so really going after the Hadoop opportunity. The other is Splunk Enterprise, you know, version 6, which brings in a lot more simplicity so that business users can start using Splunk. They're way ahead of the game. The key is they got to keep innovating, move faster, and dramatically expand the channel. I mean, it's impressive that they've got 45% of their business comes from the channel. I want to see that business, that metric go to 70% over the next 3 to 4 years.
Yeah, the other thing that's surprising here is the diversity of use cases, Dave. And one of the things that's clear is that, Splunk, like Tableau, again, growing, huge uptake on the product side. So the thing about Splunk is, they have a variety of use cases. So you talk to anyone, there's always a different little nuance. Oh, I'm using this for that, I'm using this. But the business value comes from the analytics. The analytics is a big part of it, and this notion of data modeling. And one of the things that Splunk has done very, very well is they've created the technology to automate a lot of the data modeling. So analytics is key, and the data modeling is key. Those two things alone kind of enable a variety of diverse use cases. So, you know, we heard yesterday, day one, you know, everyone's using it from driving revenue, homes.com, big companies using it. And this is hard for a company because you can get distracted on which use case drives the best value. Splunk kind of throws their hands in the air and says, hey, you know what? We enable leverage with our customers. Let the use cases play themselves out. And that's a key thing for them.
I think there's three things that Splunk is focused on, John. You mentioned the data modeling, and you're always talking about schema, flexible schema. You know a lot about that, your database background, some of the work that you've done with CrowdSpots. But so the idea that you don't have to have this rigid structure that changes, that's the problem with, and the biggest complaint you hear with the traditional BI guys is the business changes. And then the business goes, they define everything, the business, the analysts build a cube, and then something changes. And it takes months, you know, if not, you know, weeks, if not months, to change. What Splunk is doing is a much lighter weight schema, much more flexible. So flexibility is key. The other is simplicity. The whole notion of pivoting, if you will, pun intended, off the pivot tables of Microsoft's Excel, simplifying things. And the third real key competitive differentiator that companies need to focus on in this business is speed, the performance. So there's some serious tech behind technologies like Splunk. You don't just throw it out there.
Yeah, the thing I want to highlight too is that the mobile movement is really key. So BugSense is really kind of a key acquisition for them. And we heard the SVP, Guido Schroeder, talking about that with the founder of BugSense. That acquisition is super exciting. They take that web platform and move it to mobile with a whole new set of analytics. Very, very important. But the bigger picture here, Dave, and for the folks watching, we had a crowd chat this morning with the data economy hashtag. So if you go to Twitter and search on data economy, or go to crowdchat.net/data economy, you'll see that we did a crowd chat this morning. There's still 145 people online reading that transcript. It was a 1 hour chat, our new product that we soft launched. But the number one question that was voted up by the crowd was, it seems that with all the different types of data, there will be several different analytics solutions in the enterprise. Does anyone agree? And overwhelmingly, that got the most votes on our crowd chat, and there is a different set of analytical capabilities because the data diversity is really key, and that is an important point.
Well, I think I'd love that comment as well, John, and you're seeing it in the marketplace. You're seeing traditional players like Oracle, IBM, you know, going after, you know, their segment of the market. Then you see sort of the older upstarts. So this would be like guys like Vertica, certainly Netezza, which is now part of IBM, Vertica part of HP, Greenplum, which is part of EMC. They set out to disrupt the traditional, you know, Oracles of the world, really focusing on speed and MPP and loading up fast. And I think that you see Splunk adding to that diversity with a whole new paradigm of how to analyze data. So John, we got a good lineup today. We're once again wall to wall. We got a wrap here, so keep it right there, everybody.
Day two, right here live in Las Vegas for the Splunk Conference, .conference 2013. Text us, tweet to us, at Furrier, at D Vellante. I also use the hashtag Splunk Conference, SplunkConf, Splunk C-O-N-F. That's the hashtag, we're watching that. We'll be right back. Day two coverage starting right now. Be right back.